I mean, every day I ask for piggybacks off him anyway, so I'll just ask for some more. Yeah.
Hi, I'm McKenna.
Hi, I'm Amber.
And we're going to be spilling the tea on our Love Island secrets. So I was out in Shoreditch Box Park in London, and then some guy came up to me and then
scouted,
yeah. And he said, "Oh, your face would look really good on Love Island." And it turned out he was a casting director, and then it just went from there. Got my number, got my Instagram, and then just kept rolling. Really, but yeah. It was very random how I got scouted. I didn't apply or anything.
And just had someone slide into my DMs about it.
So yeah, I don't think you get told that you know until like 2 or 3 weeks before you fly out. So it's not really in advance. You just carry on with the process until they say, "Okay, cool, we want you on the show."
Yeah, I think I knew sort of early May, but I feel like you always get told sort of like you don't know if you're actually on until you're actually stepping into the villa. But I feel like if I actually read the room before, I was like, should have got the hints. But yeah, I suppose early May. I got told sort of from early May that I was going to be an original.
Yeah, I didn't know. I think originally I was meant to be a bombshell. And then I think they switched
it.
So I was meant to be a bombshell. And then they switched it. Like a week before, I think. I don't know, the timings are all like merged up in my brain.
I don't think I had any awkward conversations. I'm not really an awkward person. I'm just like,
yeah, awkward combos.
Every combo you have is just like.
Every combo I had. Nah. I don't think I had any awkward conversations.
Well, he bloody snuck gum in. Every night I'd be like, I can't.
I snuck gum in into the villa and then got taken out away from me because I gave it to too many people. Gave it out, didn't I? And then got found out.
Sharing is caring. No, I don't think I took anything. I wanted to take anything that I couldn't. Yeah. It was my phone, but it was obvious to take that. Yeah. Yeah, there was definitely a few, handful.
Yeah, I think there was quite a few, but they would want to like build a narrative in a certain way, so they wouldn't air it.
Digging them out, I see.
That's what reality TV is. So.
I feel like there weren't like random rows that were like sort of out of the blue.
Yeah.
I feel like obviously where it's just now, I suppose they probably couldn't show sort of every argument in its entirety. But yeah, I don't think there was any that sort of
stood out.
Yeah, no. Yeah. Ooh, I mean, ooh. Remy and Jack.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. Well, they're gonna have to because there's a reunion.
Yeah, there was so. opposite sides of like the party or whatever it is.
Loads of refilming. So it's like every time there's a recoupling, like they get you to do the speeches quite a few times. Like when you stand up, I remember my speech in particular, like I had to read it.
Well, because he stood up, like every time he stood up, he would make everyone laugh because he literally stood up with his bum out. He was like,
yeah,
and everyone was like, what the hell are you doing?
I stood up normally.
It's just funny.
No, not really, because then once you do it once, I think you get used to it.
I was gonna say, it's not as cringe as you think it would be, because that's the one thing that I was just like, oh, like I'm not really a public, well, I am a public speaker, but not sort of confessing my love kind of public speaker, but it's actually not as bad as you think it would be. Oh, I mean, every day I ask for piggybacks off him anyway, so I'll just ask for some more.
That there's a little door in the kitchen, and that's where people can come in and out. But they don't share that on the show. Yeah,
doors everywhere.
Door. Nah, the secret door. Blended in the kitchen.
Then throwing the phones.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you mean phones?
Yeah. Oh, throwing the phones right before text.
Oh, yeah. But I feel like they tried to like headfuck us a little bit, because then like some days we'll be like, has everyone got their phones, and we'll get like no text.
Yeah.
We was on edge all the time. Then it gets to a point where you're like, oh, drama's gonna come, so we'll just take it in our flow.
I don't know if
fake's a strong word. They really want us to get dragged. Who do you think's being fake? I don't know, because I feel like everyone has it in them to be a little bit fake, I think, as in everyone that's there, but I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe, I feel like Casa, after Casa, will know, really, truly.
For sure.
He was true with their feelings. Biggest player, Ekin-Su.
No, but I actually feel like she's been so obvious about it. Everyone knows she's playing the game, but I feel like actually an undercover player might be Jay.
I don't know. I feel like Jay didn't really get a chance. Like he came in and he liked Ekin-Su, and then he saw all the drama that came with it. I thought,
Yeah, but I think also he knew that she was going to be like, she was the one that was going to leave her couple the easiest out of all of us girls. That's why yeah. every time he spoke to us, it was like an interview. He was like, so the couples, who, like, how do you feel? We were like, is this a reporter?
Yeah.
He had bloody keto diet.
Yeah, I had a keto diet, yeah.
And then in the night, he's stuffing all the fucking snacks.
Yeah.
We had really good meals, to be honest.
Okay, good meals.
Yeah, but then every night us girls would have like the guac and chips, like drama guac and chips. Love it.
I'm McKenna.
I'm Amber.
And those were our Love Island secrets.